today start to learn to develop how to use table view to create a list of users like we see in WhatsApp chat. Let me show you what we exactly want to develop. So here you can see that we have a WhatsApp screen. On this screen we have a list of users and to which we do some chatting, users in groups. Here this list has information about user, username, user status, text status, and the time, date and time for the last chat we have done with that user or group. So we can develop a screen like this in the iOS application using table view. To develop an application like this, a screen like this, we need some images of users and a design of an item of this list. So you can see here that the item of design of each item is similar here. Each item contains an image, two labels here, one label here, one icon here. Okay, so let us try to develop a list which contains design like this. Okay, so in iOS we use table view to develop this. A table view is a collection of items. In a table view, the items can have any user interface like this, and also items can be grouped into section. Let's say these four rows are in one group and these remaining rows are in another group. So these are known as sections. So in iOS, UI table view is a collection of rows, and the rows are grouped in sections. Okay, so let's see how we can decide how many rows we can put in each section and how we can decide how many sections we can have in our screen. Since the user interface of each item is almost similar, so we develop the user interface of row first as in a template. The template which holds the user interface of a row is known as cell. So we have to develop a cell. So we can say this is a cell, and cell has one image view and three labels. Okay, so this is the design of a cell. To develop a cell, we have a class UI table view cell. It holds UI of a cell of a table view. Okay, so to develop UI we need to create and use the UI table view cell. We subclass this class and put design of cell in an XIP. So .xiv file is a file which contains actually the GUI, the design, which we can create using a storyboard mechanism. And the class that control the design is created by subclassing this class. Object of this class then will be put into or added into table. So let's see how we can do it. So I have some images or icons like this. which I will use as icons of users. Okay, so let's create an application where we can display a list or a chat list like this. So let's open Xcode and create a project. Custom cell table view like WhatsApp chat list. So this is our storyboard. So on this storyboard, I can reserve some space for that table view. So let's have a table view. So this is the table view. Let's add some constraint to this table view. 1, 1, 1. Okay, and so I have to set height, let's say 50 from the top. Okay, on this table view I want to display all the chat items, so I have to design, make a UI of a chat item, UI of a cell. So before that, I need some icons to be stored in our application for user icons. So I create new icons here. So let's say this is user one. I'm currently using same image for multiple icons, so multiple sizes of image. I'm using the same image. Now let's add some more. So this is how we collected some images and added in the image assets. Image 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, and this is, let's say, image 9. Now let us create the UI for that item of the list. So we need to create a UI which holds the template for this design. Let's take simple design first. this one, one image view which has one image view, two labels here and one label here. Let's check how we can design it. So this is a cell. Let us create a customized cell. So we create a new file for that cell. It should be Cocoa Touch class. Here we create chat list cell, subclass of UI table view cell. So you have to update the name because it is automatically changed here. So let's make it again chat list cell. Also create XIB to generate the UI part. So the one class with this name chat list cell and one UI will be generated. Let's see. So we see here two files. One is the class, subclass of table view cell, and another is the design in the XIB file. So this is our cell design container, container of the cell. It has one content view, and inside content view you can put any design. So let us add some design elements. Let us make it quick, quite increase the size, and here now let us put some content inside it. So first of all we need an icon holder. So we add an image view. So let's make it a square, 60 by 60. Let's say 70 by 70 or 75 by 75. Let's add some constraint to it. Let's say 5 pixels from right. And center horizontal in container, then a width height 75 75. So the constraints are height, width, align center x. Now also we remove this align center x, it is duplicate. In place we add align center y. So this is our image view. Let's put a default icon on it, default image. Let's image one. So it is here. Now let's add the remaining user interface. So let us add one label. This is one label. Again one more label. In this label here we add time. So 00 colon 00 for default. Let's add some constraint to it. Width, height 25, top 10, bottom left 10. This is done in the same way. Let us add some constraint to this also. Top 10, height 25, let's say 30, and some space from here, and some space from here. space of 10, again space of 5. Remove these and make the top equal. Okay. Then let's add one more label. And add some constraint to it. Width, height, top space, horizontal spacing, trailing space, make it 10, and top space again, make it 20. That's it. 10. This is name. Status text. Now its size is 75 by 75. The size of container is not 75 by 75, so let's make its height lesser than around 85. Now it looks better. We can reduce the space also. Okay. Now we have three labels: name, status text, time, and one image. So first of all, we assign an identifier to this design. Let's its name it again chat list cell. An identifier is required in the code part to access this cell at runtime. Identifier can be anything. Let's say identifier can be XYZ ABC, but to remember it, we use the same name of the class and the XIB as the identifier. Now let us create outlet for this. So let us select it from here, then go to assistant editor and create outlet for each of the item. So here we use let us create reference for image view. Username label, status text label, time label. Now this design is ready, the class is ready. What we do is now we store the data about this, data about 10 users. So to store the data about 10 users, we create a class that represents a single user, so that we can store name of the image, name of user, status text, and last time contacted. So we create a class in a Swift file. Set user. class name is, let's say, chat user. Class chat user, variable username, variable status text variable time. Variable image name, image. Let's create initializer, username, string text, time string, image string. Self dot username, equal to username. Self dot status text, equal to status text. Self dot time, equal to time. Self dot image, equal to image. So this is our class is ready. Now let us go to storyboard, and we have one table here. Let us create. Outlet of this in the view controller. So we have our view controller here. In the view controller, let us first create chat list table. So our UI of main controller is ready. Now let us add some data to our application. So we create array chat user array or chat users, an array of chat list. Class that we have just created, chat user. Let us fill this with data. Fill data in user array. So let u1 is a user, chat user, let's see what is the problem here. So we have to rename this because there is one variable declared in this class which has the same name as image view. So we, let's say, user image view. Make it user image view. Now chat user, then username. Status text, time, image. Status text, hello, time 23:09, image 1. What is image 1? So image 1 is an image stored in the assets, this one. In the same way, let us create 10 users. U2, image 2, U3, image 3, U4, H4, U5, H5, U6, H6, 7, H7, U8, H8, U9, H9. Let's change the names. Welcome. Manas Abhijit awesome today Nidal. This could be it. Backup Manoj life is precious. Good. Dev. Preparing for exam. So this is, we have 9 users. Let's add these users in user array. U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, 6, U7, U8, U9. So we added data to users chat list. So we have 10 users data we have added in the list. Let's display this data. So here you can see that we have this table view cell, and each cell has its common user interface. we'll display the data that we have developed in these cells. We generate n number of cells, that is 9 cells total. Now what we do is we organize the cells in sections. So for example, there are two sections. Let's say this is one section and this is another section. But in WhatsApp, like that, we don't need multiple sections. We can use only one section. So all the 9 rows will be displayed in one section. So let's decide how many sections we have and how many rows we have. So to decide this, we need to override one protocol, UI table view data source. This protocol gives us method to decide this data about the table. So this protocol gives you one method to decide number of sections. So if you implement this method, number of section, you have to return how many section you want in your table view. Here we want only one section. Another one is number of rows in section. So this method helps you to decide how many rows you want to create in that section. So if you return 5, it will create 5 rows. If you return 10, it will create 10 rows. And also the last is what user interface you want to provide to the cell. So since we already have developed a class for our cell, which is actually subclass of this UI table cell class, so we use that class to create our cell design. Let's go back and implement the methods. So number one, set one section in table view. So we override the method number of sections. So we return here 1. Then we override set number of rows in this section. So we override another method, number of rows in section. And if you return 3, it will create 3 rows. If you return 4, it will create 4 return. If we return set user dot count, it will create rows equal to number of items in the set users. Now this is how we decided we will have only one section and there will be 9 rows in that section. Now display UI of cells or rows. So for this we override one more method, cell for row at index path. This method helps you to create a cell object and fill it with the data of your array. So either we can directly create of this object of this class, or we can use our own custom class. Where is our custom class? So what we do is, before doing this, we go to the table view did load and add our cell design of set list cell dot xip to table view. We have to load the design, and to load the design we create object of UI NIB class. This class helps to hold the design of XIB file. The name of XIB file is set list cell. Dot XIB is not required. Bundle means which bundle contains this file. So our main bundle contains, so there is no need to pass the bundle. We just pass main nil, it will use the main bundle. Then we attach this to our table view. So we have a table view checklist table view. So we use the checklist table view dot register nib method to add this design to our table view. So this loaded design is in this object, and this object is now connected with table view. And we have to assign the identifier that we have assigned earlier. Identifier is also chat list cell. Let us verify where is the identifier. So we have already given identifier to chat list cell in the property sheet. Here. So we are using this identifier in the code. Now this is the cell design is registered with table view using this identifier. We can use this design now. So let cell equal to checklist table view dot, there is a DQ method which helps you to load the cell design. DQ reusable cell with identifier. Our identifier is chat list cell. Index path means for which row it is being generated. So we just need to pass index path. So this method execute for each row of table. And it means it execute here 9 times, and for 9 times every time it execute the index part dot row contains the position of the current row for which the UI is being generated. So we pass the index path object here, then we can return the cell, but we don't want to return the cell as it is without the data. So let's see what is happening till now. Let's see what is the output of this code. So we want every cell to be generated and contain the data like this. Currently our design is this, so it will display this user interface. And this method helps to generate 9 cells using this mechanism, but we don't see any data here. The reason being that the code is still not working. We have implemented all 3 methods, so we have to tell our table view that we have implemented the data source in the current class, so it will look for all the method in the current class. So current class object is attached, so the table view later can call these method to generate sections, rows and the cell of each row. Let us see if you attach the code for the current object of this class. So here you can see that we have all the cells generated with the default data which we have provided in the design time, but the size of the cell is not exactly what we see here. So what we do is we provide one property on the update one property of table view in the size inspector. We give the row height as 80 because our one cell size is 75 by IT 75, so we make it 80, and then we'll run it again and check whether we have the same cell size. So it's working now. Now what we do is we have to add the data corresponding to each cell. So this cell is generated because of this code, but only the default cell is generated. The cell is not filled with the data. So what we do is we use cell dot image view. So cell has the image view. You can check that this class has all image view and labels. One is what are the labels in the chat list? So username label, text label, time label. So we can fill with the data. Where is the data? Data is present in the array. So first of all, we get the data from the array. Get data of cell from corresponding object of array. So let's take the data. Let user is equal to set users of index path dot row. The row gives the current position of the cell for which the UI is being generated. So in the cell object dot image view, user image view, equal to, we create a UI dot image UI image named user object dot image. So let's see, is there any syntax error? Remember the user image view. Let's see what is the syntax problem. Okay, so since the output of this function is of type UIW cell, so we have to convert it as chat list cell. Now it can recognize the elements for chat list cell. In the same way, cell dot status text label dot text equal to user dot status text, cell dot time label dot text equal to user dot time, cell dot name label dot text equal to user dot user name. So our cell which we have loaded is now filled with the data from the array object. Now let's see if we can run it. So so the image name may be some issue in the image name. So let's see what is the name of image we have here. So assets has image 1. So let's give it a name, image 1. image 2, image 3, image 4, image 5, image 6, image 7, image 8, and image 9. And let's go to storyboard of this cell design and let us see if there is some issue with the design part. Yes, this image is not connected, so we disconnect it and we have user image view and new label. So we connect it like this and we have updated the name of assets. Let's update the name of assets. Image 1, image 2, image 3, image 4, image 5, image 6, image 7, image 8, image 9. Let's run it again if we see all the images and their data. Okay, so now you can see that we have generated an image in a list of users similar to what we see in the WhatsApp application. So it's not a tough task here. TableView helps you to generate the list like this and it is customized. Now let us handle the selection of item in the table. Let us handle it. So to handle it, we need to override one more method, and that method is handle list row selection. So to handle list row selection, we need to override did select row, but there is no method available. That method is available in different protocol. That protocol is UI table view delegate. We use this protocol and now did select row. So at index path, so as and when user selects the row, this method will execute and this method gives you the index path, that is position of the cell. So let position is equal to index path dot row. This is the selected position. Let selected user equal to chat users array of position. So we have the data about the selected user using this mechanism, and let's print it somewhere in the console. You can utilize it somewhere else if you want. So user is selected user dot user name. Okay, so we have implemented new method and this new method is from new protocol. So we have to tell our table view, this new method is from this new protocol table view delegate. We have to tell checklist table view that we have implemented this protocol also. So checklist table view dot delegate property helps to assign the object which implemented the protocol. At runtime, the table view can use this object to execute the method on selection. Okay, So let's click on here, Ankur. Now you can see here, username Ankur. Let's click on Abhijit, Abhijit, Gurmeet, Rahul, like. So this is how we are able to select each of them. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.